This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Great Britain, also known as Britain. United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland, which was renamed the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland after the Irish Free State seceded in 1922. Contents 1. Terminology 11. Toponymy 12. Derivation of Great 13. Modern use of the term Great Britain 14. Political definition 2. History 21. Prehistoric period 22. Roman and medieval period 23. Early modern period 3. Geography 31. Geology 32. Fauna 33. Flora 34. Fungi 4. Demographics 41. Settlements 411. Capitals 42. Language 43. Religion 5. See also 6. Notes 7. References 71. Bibliography 8. External links 81. Video links. Terminology see also. Terminology of the British Isles. Toponymy. Main article. Britain. Place name. The archipelago has been referred to by a single name for over 2,000 years. The term British Isles derives from terms used by classical geographers to describe this island group by 50 BC. Greek geographers were using equivalents of Britannicae as a collective name for the British Isles. However, with the Roman conquest of Britain, the Latin term Britannia was used for the island of Great Britain, and later Roman occupied Britain south of Caledonia. The earliest known name for Great Britain is Albion Greek, Albion or Insula Albionum, from either the Latin albus meaning white, referring to the white cliffs of Dover. The first view of Britain from the continent or the island of the Albiones, first mentioned in the Massaliote Periplus in the 6th century BC, and by Pytheas. The oldest mention of terms related to Great Britain was by Aristotle c. 384-322 BC, or possibly by Pseudo-Aristotle, in his text on the universe, volume 3. To quote his works, there are two very large islands in it, called the British Isles, Albion and Eirne. Pliny the Elder CAD 23-79 in his Natural History Records of Great Britain, its former name was Albion, but at a later period, all the islands, of which we shall just now briefly make mention, were included under the name of Britanniae. The name Britain descends from the Latin name for Britain, Britannia or Britannia, the land of the Britons. Old French Bretagne, whence also modern French Britannia and Middle English Bretagne. Bretagne, the French form, replaced the Old English Breton, Breoton, Brighton, Breton, also Breton Londe, Breton Londe. Britannia was used by the Romans from the 1st century BC for the British Isles. Taken together, it is derived from the travel writings of the ancient Greek Pytheas around 320 BC, which described various islands in the North Atlantic as far north as Thule, probably Norway. Marcion of Heraclea, in his Periplus Maris Exteri, described the island group as Hypritonicae Nessoi, the Britannic Isles. The peoples of these islands of Britannicae were called the Britannoi. Britanni or Britanni. Britanni is the source of the Welsh language term Prydain, Britain, which has the same source as the Goidelic term Cruthni, used to refer to the early Brythonic-speaking inhabitants of Ireland. The latter were later called Picts or Caledonians by the Romans, derivation of Great. The Greco-Egyptian scientist Ptolemy referred to the larger island as Great Britain. Megales Bretagnes, Megalis Bretagnes, and to Ireland as Little Britain. Mikras Bretagnes, Mikras Bretagnes, in his work Almagest 147-148 AD. In his later work, Geography c. 150 AD, he gave these islands the names Alwyon, Iwernia, and Mona, the Isle of Man, suggesting these may have been names of the individual islands not known to him at the time of writing Almagest. The name Albion appears to have fallen out of use sometime after the Roman conquest of Great Britain, after which Britain became the more commonplace name for the island called Great Britain after the Anglo-Saxon period. Britain was used as a historical term only Geoffrey of Monmouth in his pseudo-historical Historia Regum Britanniae c. Lesser Britain, the continental region which approximates to modern Brittany, which had been settled in the 5th and 6th centuries by Celtic immigrants from the British Isles. The term Great Britain was first used officially in 1474, in the instrument drawing up the proposal for a marriage between Cecily, the daughter of Edward IV of England, and James, the son of James III of Scotland, which described it as this noble isle, call it Great Brittany. It was used again in 1604, when King James VI and I styled himself King of Great Britain, France and Ireland. Modern use of the term Great Britain. Great Britain refers geographically to the island of Great Britain, politically to England, Scotland and Wales in combination. However, it is sometimes used loosely to refer to the whole of the United Kingdom. The term Britain, as opposed to Great Britain, has been used to mean the United Kingdom formally, for example in official government yearbooks between 1975 and 2001. Since since 2002, however, the yearbooks have only used the term United Kingdom. GB and GBR are used instead of UK in some international codes to refer to the United Kingdom, including the Universal Postal Union, international sports teams, NATO, the International Organization for Standardization Country Codes ISO 3166-2 and ISO 3166-1 Alpha 3, and international license plate codes. On the Internet, UK is the country code top-level domain for the United Kingdom. AGB top-level domain was used to a limited extent, but is now obsolete because the domain name registrar will not take new registrations in the Olympics. Team GB is used by the British Olympic Association to represent the Great Britain and Northern Ireland Olympic team. The British Grand Prix of Motor Racing is another example of a use of Britain in place of the United Kingdom. Political definition. Political definition of Great Britain: dark green. Personal union had existed between these two countries since the 1603 Union of the Crowns under James VI of Scotland and I of England. History. Prehistoric period. Main article. Prehistoric Britain. The island was first inhabited by people who crossed over the land bridge from the European mainland. Human footprints have been found from over 800,000 years ago in Norfolk, and traces of early humans have been found at Boxgrove Quarry, Sussex, from some 500,000 years ago, and modern humans from about 30,000 years ago and till about 14,000 years ago. Great Britain was connected to Ireland, and as recently as 8,000 years ago it retained a land connection to the continent, with an area of mostly low marshland joining it to what are now Denmark and the Netherlands in Cheddar Gorge, near Bristol. The remains of animal species native to mainland Europe such as antelopes, brown bears, and wild horses have been found alongside a human skeleton, Cheddar Man, dated to about 7150 BC. Thus, animals and humans must have moved between mainland Europe and Great Britain via a crossing. Great Britain became an island at the end of the last glacial period when sea levels rose due to the combination of melting glaciers and the subsequent isostatic rebound of the crust. Great Britain's Iron Age inhabitants are known as Britons. They spoke Celtic languages. Roman and medieval period. Main articles. Roman Britain, medieval England, medieval Scotland, and medieval Wales. Prima Europe. Tabula. A copy of Ptolemy's 2nd century map of Roman Britain. The Romans conquered most of the island up to Hadrian's Wall, in northern England, and this became the ancient Roman province of Britannia in the course of the 500 years after the Roman Empire fell. The Britons of the south and east of the island were assimilated or displaced by invading Germanic tribes. Angles, Saxons, and Jutes, often referred to collectively as Anglo-Saxons, at about the same time. Gaelic tribes from Ireland invaded the northwest, absorbing both the Picts and Britons of northern Britain, eventually forming the Kingdom of Scotland in the 9th century. The southeast of Scotland was colonised by the Angles and formed, until 1018, a part of the Kingdom of Northumbria. Ultimately, the population of southeast Britain came to be referred to as the English people, so named after the Angles. Germanic speakers referred to Britons as Welsh. This term came to be applied exclusively to the inhabitants of what is now Wales, but it also survives in names such as Wallace and in the second syllable of Cornwall. Cymry, a name the Britons used to describe themselves, is similarly restricted in modern Welsh to people from Wales, but also survives in English in the place name of Cumbria. The Britons living in the areas now known as Wales, Cumbria, and Cornwall were not assimilated by the Germanic tribes, a fact reflected in the survival of Celtic languages in these areas into more recent times. At the time of the Germanic invasion of southern Britain, many Britons emigrated to the area now known as Brittany, where Breton, a Celtic language closely related to Welsh and Cornish and descended from the language of the emigrants, is still spoken in the 9th century. A series of Danish assaults on northern English kingdoms led to them coming under Danish control, an area known as the Danelaw, in the 10th century. However, all the English kingdoms were unified under one ruler as the Kingdom of England when the last constituent kingdom, Northumbria, submitted to Edgar in 959. In 1066, England was conquered by the Normans, who introduced a Norman-speaking administration that was eventually assimilated. Wales came under Anglo-Norman control in 1282, and was officially annexed to England in the 16th century. Early modern period. Main article. Early modern Britain. Further information. History of the United Kingdom. On the 20th of October 1604, King James, who had succeeded separately to the two thrones of England and Scotland, proclaimed himself King of Great Britain, France, and Ireland. When James died in 1625 and the Privy Council of England was drafting the proclamation of the new king, Charles I, a Scottish peer, Thomas Erskine, 1st Earl of Kelly, succeeded in insisting that it use the phrase King of Great Britain, which James had preferred, rather than King of Scotland and England or vice versa. While that title was also used by some of James's successors, England and Scotland each remained legally separate countries, each with its own parliament, until 1707, when each parliament passed an Act of Union to ratify the Treaty of Union that had been agreed the previous year. This created a single kingdom out of two, with a single parliament, with effect from 1 May 1707. The Treaty of Union specified the name of the new All Island state as Great Britain, while describing it as one kingdom and the United Kingdom to most historians. Therefore, the All Island state that existed between 1707 and 1800 is Great Britain or the Kingdom of Great Britain. Geography. Further information: Geography of England, Geography of Scotland, and Geography of Wales. See also Geography of the United Kingdom. View of Britain's coast from northern France. Great Britain lies on the European continental shelf, part of the Eurasian plate, situated off the northwest coast of continental Europe. It is separated from the mainland by the North Sea and by the English Channel, which narrows to 34 surrounding islands. The North Channel, Irish Sea, St. George's Channel and Celtic Sea separate the island from the island of Ireland to its west. The island is physically connected with continental Europe via the Channel Tunnel, the longest undersea rail tunnel in the world, completed in 1993. The island is marked by low, rolling countryside in the east and south, while hills and mountains predominate in the western and northern regions. It is surrounded by over 1,000 smaller islands and islets. The greatest distance between two points is 9,680 European mainland by around 6500 BC. Geology. Main article: Geology of Great Britain. Great Britain has been subject to a variety of plate tectonic processes over a very extended period of time. Changing latitude and sea levels have been important factors in the nature of sedimentary sequences, whilst successive continental collisions have affected its geological structure, with major faulting and folding being a legacy of each orogeny mountain building period, often associated with volcanic activity and the metamorphism of existing rock sequences as a result of this eventful geological history. The island shows a rich variety of landscapes. The oldest rocks in Great Britain are the Laewesian gneisses, metamorphic rocks found in the far northwest of the island and in the Hebrides, with a few small outcrops elsewhere, which date from at least 2,700 ma-ma-equals-million years ago. South of the gneisses are a complex mixture of rocks forming the Northwest Highlands and Grampian Highlands in Scotland. These are essentially the remains of folded sedimentary rocks that were deposited between 1,000 ma and 670 ma over the gneiss on what was then the floor of the Iapetus Ocean. At the present time, the north of the island is rising as a result of the weight of Devonian ice being lifted. Southern and eastern Britain is sinking, generally estimated at 1/125. Are found on or around British shores and coastlines. The largest land-based wild animals today are deer. The red deer is the largest species, with roe deer and fallow deer also prominent. The latter was introduced by the Normans. Sika deer and two more species of smaller deer, muntjac and Chinese water deer, have been introduced, muntjac becoming widespread in England and parts of Wales, while Chinese water deer are restricted mainly to East Anglia. Habitat loss has affected many species. Extinct large mammals include the brown bear, grey wolf and wild boar. The latter has had a limited reintroduction in recent times. There is a wealth of bird life, 583 species in total, of which 258 breed on the island or remain during winter because of its mild winters for its latitude. Great Britain hosts important numbers of many wintering species, particularly ducks, geese and swans. Other well-known bird species include the golden eagle, grey heron, kingfisher, pigeon, sparrow, pheasant, partridge, and various species of crow, finch, gull, auk, grouse, owl and falcon. There are six species of reptile on the island, three snakes and three lizards including the legless slow worm. One snake, the adder, is venomous but rarely deadly. Amphibians present are frogs, toads and newts. Flora. See also, list of the vascular plants of Britain and Ireland. Heather growing wild in the highlands at Dornoch. In a similar sense to fauna, and for similar reasons, the flora is impoverished compared to that of continental Europe. The flora comprises 3,354 vascular plant species, of which 2,297 are native and 1,057 have been introduced. The island has a wide variety of trees, including native species of birch, beech, ash, hawthorn, elm, oak, yew, pine, cherry and apple. Other trees have been naturalized, introduced especially from other parts of Europe, particularly particularly Norway and North America introduced trees include several varieties of pine, chestnut, maple, spruce, sycamore and fir, as well as cherry plum and pear trees. The tallest species are the Douglas firs. Two specimens have been recorded measuring 65 meters or 212 feet. The Fortingall yew in Perthshire is the oldest tree in Europe. There are at least 1,500 different species of wildflower. Some 107 species are particularly rare or vulnerable and are protected by the Wildlife and Countryside Act 1981. It is illegal to uproot any wildflowers without the landowner's permission. A vote in 2002 nominated various wildflowers to represent specific counties. These include red poppies, bluebells, daisies, daffodils, rosemary, gorse, iris, ivy, mint, orchids, brambles, thistles, buttercups, primrose, thyme, tulips, violets, cowslip, heather and many more. There are also many species of algae and mosses across the island. Fungi. There are many species of fungi including lichen-forming species, and the mycobiota is less poorly known than in many other parts of the world. The most recent checklist of Basidiomycota bracket fungi, jelly fungi, mushrooms and toadstools, puffballs, rusts and smuts, published in 2005, accepts over 3,600 species. The most recent checklist of Ascomycota cup fungi and their allies, including most lichen-forming fungi, published in 1985, accepts another 5,100 species. These two lists did not include conidial fungi. Fungi mostly with affinities in the Ascomycota Mycota, but known only in their asexual state, or any of the other main fungal groups: Chytridiomycota, Glomeromycota, and Zygomycota. The number of fungal species known very probably exceeds 10,000. There is widespread agreement among mycologists that many others are yet to be discovered. Demographic settlements. Capitals. London is the capital of England and the United Kingdom, and is the seat of the United Kingdom's government. Edinburgh and Cardiff are the capitals of Scotland and Wales, respectively, and house their devolved governments. Largest urban areas. See all. Also, list of urban areas in the United Kingdom. Rank. City region built up area population 2011. Birmingham Wolverhampton West Midlands built up area 2,440,986 5,989 4,076 4 Leeds Bradford West Yorkshire built up area 1,777,934 4,878 3,645 5 Glasgow Greater Glasgow built up area 1,209,143 3,685 3,396 Liverpool. Liverpool built up area 864,122 1996 4,329 7 Southampton. Portsmouth. South Hampshire built up area 855,569 1920 4,455 8 Newcastle upon Tyne. Sunderland. Tyneside built up area 774,891 1805 4,292 9 Nottingham. Nottingham built up area 729,977 1764 4,139 10 Sheffield. Sheffield built up area 685,368 1675 4,092 Language. Further information: Languages of England, Languages of Scotland, and Languages of Wales. See also: Languages of the United Kingdom in the Late Bronze Age. Britain was part of a culture called the Atlantic Bronze Age, held together by maritime trading, which also included Ireland, France, Spain and Portugal, in contrast to the generally accepted view that Celtic originated in the context of the Hallstatt culture. Since 2009, John T. Koch and others have proposed that the origins of the Celtic languages are to be sought in Bronze Age Western Europe, especially the Iberian Peninsula. Koch et al.'s proposal has failed to find wide acceptance among experts on the Celtic languages. All the modern Brythonic languages, Breton, Cornish, Welsh, are generally considered to derive from a common ancestral language termed Brythonic, British, Common Brythonic, Old Brythonic, or Proto-Brythonic, which is thought to have developed from Proto-Celtic or early Insular Celtic by the 6th century AD. Brythonic languages were probably spoken before the Roman invasion, at least in the majority of Great Britain south of the rivers Forth and Clyde, though the Isle of Man later had a Goidelic language. Manx. Northern Scotland mainly spoke Prytnic, which became Pictish, which may have been a Brythonic language during the period of the Roman occupation of southern Britain AD 43 to c. 410. Common Brythonic borrowed a large stock of Latin words. Approximately 800 of these Latin loan words have survived in the three modern Brythonic languages. Romano-British is the name for the Latinized form of the language used by Roman authors. British English is spoken in the present day across the island, and developed from the Old English brought to the island by Anglo-Saxon settlers from the mid-5th century. Some 15 million people speak Scots, a variety of English which some consider to be a distinct language. An estimated 700,000 people speak Welsh, an official language in Wales. In parts of Northwest Scotland, Scottish Gaelic remains widely spoken. There are various regional dialects of English, and numerous languages spoken by recent immigrant populations. Religion. Further information: religion in England, religion in Scotland, and religion in Wales. See also: religion in the United Kingdom. Canterbury Cathedral, seat of the Church of England, the island's largest denomination. Christianity has been the largest religion by number of adherents since the early Middle Ages. It was introduced under the ancient Romans, developing as Celtic Christianity. According to tradition, Christianity arrived in the 1st or 2nd century. The most popular form is Anglicanism, known as Episcopalism in Scotland, dating from the 16th century Reformation. It regards itself as both Catholic and Reformed. The head of the Church is the monarch of the United Kingdom. As the supreme governor, it has the status of established church. In England, there are just over 26 million adherents to Anglicanism in Britain today, although only around 1 million regularly attend services. The second largest Christian practice is the Latin Rite of the Roman Catholic Church, which traces its history to the 6th century with Augustine's mission and was the main religion for around 1,000 years. There are over 5 million adherents today, 45 million in England and Wales and 750,000 in Scotland, although fewer than 1 million Catholics regularly attend Mass. Glasgow Cathedral, a meeting place of the Church of Scotland. The Church of Scotland, a form of Protestantism with a Presbyterian system of ecclesiastical polity, is the third most numerous on the island with around 21 million members. Introduced in Scotland by clergyman John Knox, it has the status of national church in Scotland. The monarch of the United Kingdom is represented by a Lord High Commissioner. Methodism is the fourth largest and grew out of Anglicanism through John Wesley. It gained popularity in the old mill towns of Lancashire and Yorkshire. Also amongst tin miners in Cornwall. The Presbyterian Church of Wales, which follows Calvinistic Methodism, is the largest denomination in Wales. There are other non-conformist minorities, such as Baptists, Quakers, the United Reformed Church, a union of Congregationalists and English Presbyterians, Unitarians. The first patron saint of Great Britain was Saint Alban. He was the first Christian martyr, dating from the Romano-British period, condemned to death for his faith and sacrificed to the pagan gods in more recent times. Some have suggested the adoption of Saint Aidan as another patron saint of Britain. From Ireland, he worked at Iona amongst the Dáil Riata and then Lindisfarne, where he restored Christianity to Northumbria. The three constituent countries of the United Kingdom have patron saints. Saint George and Saint Andrew are represented in the flags of England and Scotland respectively. These two flags combined to form the basis of the Great Britain Royal Flag of 1604. Saint David is the patron saint of Wales. There are many other British saints. Some of the best known are Cuthbert, Columba, Patrick, Margaret, Edward the Confessor, Mungo, Thomas More, Petrarch, Bede, and Thomas Becket. Numerous other religions are practiced. Jews have inhabited Britain since 1070. Jews were expelled from England in 1290 but allowed to return in 1656. There were also Jewish migrations from Lithuania. The 2001 census recorded that Islam had around 15 million adherents. More than 1 million people practice either Hinduism, Sikhism, or Buddhism. Religions introduced from the Indian subcontinent and Southeast Asia. See also United Kingdom. Portal Islands. Portal. List of islands of England. List of islands of Scotland. List of islands of Wales. Notes. Carat. The political definition of Great Britain, that is, England, Scotland and Wales combined, includes a number of offshore islands such as the Isle of Wight, Anglesey and Shetland, which are not part of the geographical island of Great Britain. Those three countries combined have a total area of 234,402. The 14th of November 2010 retrieved the 24th of September 2010. Carat. Definitions and recommended usage varies. For example, the Oxford English Dictionary defines Britain as an island and Great Britain as a political unit formed by England, Scotland and Wales, whereas the Cambridge Guide to English Usage gives Britain as familiar shorthand for Great Britain, the island which geographically contains England, Wales and Scotland. Carat. O'Rahilly 1946 to the power of 420 provides a translation describing Caesar's first invasion, using terms which from IVXX appear in Latin as arriving in Britannia, the inhabitants being Britanni, and on p30 Principes Britanniae, i.e., Chiefs of Britannia, is translated as Chiefs of Britain. Carat. Cunliffe 2002, pp. Nesoi magistoi tinchinusin usai dyo, Bretonikai legomene, Albion kai irn, Aristotle, on sophistical refutations on coming to be and passing away on the cosmos 393b, pages 360-361, Loeb Classical Library No. 400, London William Heinemann Ltd., Cambridge Massachusetts University Press MCMLV Carat Pliny The Elders Naturalis Historia Book IV Chapter 41 Latin text and English translation, numbered Book 4, Chapter 30, At the Perseus Project Carat Martianus Heraclensis, Muller, Karl Ottfried, et al. 1855, Periplus Maris Exteri, Liber Prior, Pruemium. In Firmin Didot, Ambrosio Geographie Grisci Minores 1 Paris pp. Carat Claudius Ptolemy 1843, Book 2, Pruemium and Chapter Beta, Paragraph 12. In Knob, Carolus Fridericus Augustus Claudii Ptolemaii Geographia PDF Volume 1 Leipzig, Sumptibus et Typus Caroli Tauchniti pp. PDF London, Office for National Statistics August 2000, ISBN. Carat Ellis, Peter Beresford 1974 The Cornish Language and Its Literature London, Routledge. Carat Vincent Gaffney, Global Warming and the Lost European Country PDF retrieved 24 February 2012. 16 February 2009 Carat Birds Nature Gridorguk. Retrieved on 23 February 2009 Carat County Flowers of Great Britain Wildeboutflowerskook archived from the original on 27 April 2009. Carat A. B. Eska, Joseph F. Bryn Mawr Classical Review 20,131,235. Bryn Mawr Classical Review Bryn Mawr College retrieved 2 September 2014. Carat BWRDD Year I8 Gymraeg, A Statistical Overview of the Welsh Language, by Howell M. Jones, page 115, 13516, England published February 2012 retrieved 28 March 2016 Carat Welsh Language Wales Measure 2011 Legislation Govic The National Archives retrieved 30 May 2016. Retrieved on 1 February 2009 Carat Cambridge History of Christianity Hugh MacLeod. On 9 May 2005.